listening to IBNX. IBNXradio.com.
Hi, this is Jess.
And Elsie.
Money in the bank. Tuning in to the show, make you laugh, make you think. Up next, IBNX in a glide, send a text. Save an Instagram picture, the symbol of success. Jay Bizzle and you listening to Hova. Here comes Monday, 7 p.m., you know what. Grab your phone, grab your tablet, computer. Boyfriends are asking why you listening to the roof. Tell you turn it off or you tell them that's stupid. Whatever you was listening to, well, it's that new shit. Topics, crazy holidays, okay. Celebrity guests, a couple statements to change. We the new reason you be listening to the radio. J-Boy and Hova, the moment that you've been waiting for. J-C Squared, you rockin' with J-C Squared. Yes, it's J-C Squared, you rockin' with J-C Squared. Let's go, J-C Squared, you rockin' with J-C Squared. Let's go, J-C Squared, you rockin' with J-C Squared.
C squared.
Let's go.
J C squared.
Let's go.
You know what it sounds like? Stressed. Sound like everybody had a long weekend.
Stressed. Let's go.
Let's go.
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 I got a migraine.
Jesus. You already know what it is. It's Monday. JC Squared on the IBNX Radio. It's your man Jason. One word. All caps. Caps. City. What up, Hope?
What up, everybody?
What up, Pedro?
Que pasa?
My man Jackson with a D. Yes.
What it do, Playboy?
Y'all tuning in, man, to listen to us talk about what's happening in the world and what in the world happened.
For real.
So, how was your weekend, Pedro?
My weekend was good, man. It was fun packed. You know, I had a lot of family time, you know.
Family time. Mm. Okay. All right, that's good. That's always good. How about you, Hope?
My weekend was flexible.
Flexible. Yeah. Wait a minute.
Yep. Been in the corners. I was gone.
Okay. I am rooting for you and disturbed at the same time.
but you working for the Alvin Ailey dancers?
How was your weekend, Jackson? I'm a little frightened.
You know what I'm saying? I feel like I want to jump on his train. I was empowered.
I came alive.
I was King Kong.
But today, I think, like today it just continued as enlightening. I had an enlightening. It's like, I don't know, the light bulb. Remember I said last week, we're still in the middle of self-improvement month, right? And getting more organized and concise. And, man, I got the answers to everything today, I feel like. Like, all sorts of new things are working right. I had a productive business day today, man. So it's like...
That's good. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, man. It was one of those... I was like, man, ask me something right now. I need, the cure to what? I got you. That's how I feel right now. I feel like I got the answers to everything today. Yeah. I don't know why. It may not be like that tomorrow, but today I feel good, man. It's a good feeling too, man. There's some good things working out. I don't know if I'm at liberty to talk about it just yet, but
understood.
So things are coming. Well, the merch store is coming. Jason Curry merch store is definitely coming along. So y'all go by the website and have me see something, y'all. We just kicking it off. It's no official launch yet. But
gotcha.
Yeah, man. But all sorts of things are happening, and it's dope. But we can take a little break because it's going to be a good day. It's going to be a good show. Take a little break. We'll be right back. IBNX Radio. Oh, yeah? Oh. Okay, that was the break. Was a moment of silence, is what we did.
Pause.
Got it. A little break. Okay, man. Listen. Anyway, let's just get into it. You know how we got to start the show.
News and hot topics.
So, what you got for us in sports today, Hope?
Yeah. So the Atlanta Falcons played this weekend.
They did.
They lost to the Colts, 27-24.
Man, but you know, people are sleeping on Jacoby Brissett, man. They're really looking down their nose on him, but the Patriots didn't really want to let him go. So, you know.
So, that's it for football, or we just talk about our local sports? I know the Chiefs are 3-0.
I'm saying, boy, woo-hoo-hoo. That's all I got to say.
On the fringes of sports, because the good thing about when Hope does sports, anybody's listening, we don't just talk about the scores and what's happening on the field, but we talk about the underbelly, the underlying, underlying stories. But in that, this weekend, the future of the NFL, the future of quarterbacks is what they think played against each other, with the Chiefs playing Baltimore Ravens. And they oh my God, they killed Lamar Jackson. They wanted him. He can't do this. He can't do that. And he's still playing well. He had a great game. Both of them had great games. And these two black guys playing quarterback and being called the future of the NFL, that's actually a win.
No, it was great. It was a good game, win. Dude. You're right.
And it could still be, well, it would be the AFC Championship if they meet, but.
And also the Saints' backup quarterback had a hell of a game, too.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Because nobody talks about that Teddy Bridgewater, they were like, well, they wasn't sure about him, but the game plan has always been for Drew's strength. This is the first time with those weapons that the game plan was for his strengths. And so, black quarterbacks. And I don't know if you've been watching football, college football either. Mm-hmm. You notice it's a lot of brothers playing in a lot of different places that didn't used to have brother quarterbacks. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So just pay attention. It's a shame in 2019 we're talking about black quarterbacks. Yeah. That we got to still
guess
talk
what?
About that. But
speaking of black quarterbacks.
Okay.
Colin Kaepernick.
Oh, God.
He actually, his Nike ad won the Emmy. Dream Crazy.
Uh-huh.
Won the Emmy. So celebrating.
Do you get an extra check for winning an Emmy?
Hold on. Talk about.
Well, you do because you go later, like, I'm an Emmy award winning such and such, and then your numbers can go up. But
talk about, did you?
His resume extends, yeah.
When I mentioned his name, I'm usually the one to be like, ah, fud. You feel like me now. That's what's happening.
Well, because. Mm-hmm. People have Colin Kaepernick as a leader, and he never was. He never was a vocal leader on the field, and you want him to talk off the field, and he's not going to talk. And I didn't know what you were going to say when you said his name. I just didn't know what the story was going to be. Congratulations. I got nothing against homie, and that's probably about all I got to say about that. I will say that people keep on carrying the flag of justice for Colin, but newsflash, he don't want to play football, dog. I'm trying to tell you. Because if you wanted to play football, you would have, because his girl said he gets up every day at 5 a.m., he works out, and he's still throwing, he's ready just in case he gets the call. But if you wanted to play ball, like three or four other leagues then popped up since you've been out of there. Yep. And you got the Canadian League. All you had to do was go ball out, just like the players that went and balled out in arena football and got back in the league, XFL players that got in the league. Mm-hmm. Like, go ball out and get back on the field if that's what you wanted to do. He don't want to play. Bottom line. Mm-hmm. So y'all gonna have to find a new hero because he don't want to play. Moving on.
Shout out to Jay-Z. Virginia basketball coach Tony Bennett turns down a raise after winning the national title.
Two up, two down.
And he said, basically, I have more than enough, and if there was any way that this can help out the athletic department, the other programs and coaches, by not tying up so much in my program, that's my desire. And that's big, and we want to correlate that to getting a new job. And if you're at a job, you work your life towards this, and they offer you a raise, would you spread it among your coworkers? You know, and be like, hey, I don't need that raise, but let my coworkers get it. How would you handle that, Jackson? Moment of silence.
There's no silence.
I don't want to put. I don't.
What you thinking?
There's multiple perspectives on that. I can't say I would be as genuine. You know what I'm saying? It's like,
oh boy, it's testing you. Oh,
it is. You know, it tests your character. I said test this. I hate broken English, incorrect words. It does. I think that's at that moment, that's testing your character, your integrity, in a sense. But I think there's that part of me. Can I give just a small percentage?
You said
can
small
I be
percentage.
Can I be genuine with a percentage? To say I still gave, but I don't feel as bad.
I think it's cool. I think it was cool to read that story. It was. I don't know the word I'm looking for, but I guess refreshing to see that another coach could have made more millions after his students, who don't get paid, won a national championship. But he was like, yo, I don't need that. I don't need that. Pay my coaches. Pay the coaches in lacrosse. Pay the coaches in field hockey. Lacrosse, they got a national championship lacrosse team over there at that school, too. Pay them would have been, I guess, the next level, though, is if he said, take that money and pay my players. That would have probably been, that would have been the next level. But it of course, you can't do that. Right. But that would have been the next level of generosity. I'm not going to take it. I wish we could take that money and figure out how to take care of the student athletes.
Mm. Well, shout out to Coach. And then
he had some. Hold on. Go
ahead, Pedro.
Well, I was going to say that what he did, you know, was a big step for all of the other programs. You know what I mean? Because those programs don't get the money that football brings in. You know what I mean? So to say, hey,
basketball.
At least you guys, I mean, I'm sorry, that basketball brings in, but at least, hey, you know, you guys get to get some type of a raise, you know, because mm-hmm. I guarantee you that the pay gap between basketball, football, and lacrosse is huge.
Mm, true.
True.
It's huge. And I don't want to sound, you know, like devil's advocate, but.
You love devil's advocate, though.
But you are
the devil.
The devil's
not welcome.
The devil is not welcome.
But each coach has the same job.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? They're bringing in athletes, and they're providing them with an education, you know what I mean, and a future. You feel me? And the same counseling that goes on as a coach in each program mm-hmm. is the same.
I want to say something about that, though. Oh. The statement you just made, providing them with the future. So, quick story. I watched Netflix the QB1 documentary where they follow these number one quarterbacks, which I'm loving watching. I watched Justin Fields, who went to Kennesaw to play for Ohio State now. Transferred from Georgia, and he's still winning. He's doing a great job.
Right.
It was dope to see that. So following these players, it was a player out of New Orleans, Louisiana, went to play for Maryland. He picked Maryland as a school. He was recruited by all top SEC schools. He picked Maryland to go play football, which is weird. But I wanted to look at the depth chart. I go to Maryland, and I look at the depth chart to see where he is. But I'm going down these athletes, and he got everybody's major.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody's major is family science. I'm like, what the hell is a family science degree? I'm going, so then I go do some research and get rabbit hole because, you know, I'm data junkie, so I need to know more.
Right.
And family science, they said, with this degree, is so if you want to be a counselor. I said, so all these football players about to be counselors. This sounds like a bullish degree that y'all. So you're not really providing a future for anybody. So all of them are going to have to go back to school because I can't see all of them wanting to be counselors.
But I had a football player as a counselor in college. They come back after they knee injury.
Exactly. I think that this is probably the easiest curriculum for their traveling and everything else. I feel like this is a hiding curriculum. You know, like in the Army, you got a special name for this covert operations. You'd be like, yeah, I'm a clerk. That's what this is.
It used to be. Most of them used to be like undecided or something like that. Or African American studies.
Counseling your family?
That's a real degree.
After he just skipped all these teams, you're going to be a family counselor?
It's a real degree.
Anthony Brown, Antonio.
But
thank you.
But
carry on.
At the same time, they have the opportunity, so they're already in the door. And what you do with that opportunity is
on you.
Is on you.
True.
And last but not least, I just want to give the top 10 in college football. Clemson is number one. Alabama's number two, Georgia's number three, and balling out. LSU number four, Ohio State, the Ohio State Buckeyes. Number five, Oklahoma six, Auburn seven, Wisconsin eight, Florida's nine, and 10 is Notre Dame. And I'm so happy because Notre Dame lost to Georgia, so that means they won't be in one of the playoffs.
Playoffs.
I'm so happy.
Gotcha.
There's some other stories that happen in sports, but we're gonna move on for that. Is this all you got for today?
Yes, sir.
This and that stupid news, really, but it's not that stupid. Y'all see the story about the man drowned after he went underwater and proposed his wife? He had a note in a Ziploc bag. On one side, it said, I can't hold my breath long enough to tell you all the things, all the love I have for you. And on the other side, it said, will you marry me?
Mm-hmm.
So it's one of those underwater pools that had a window,
mm-hmm.
and he's underwater swimming, and he flips it,
right?
But then the story comes out that he drowned.
That was smart, because usually when you get married, you die.
Wait, hold on.
So it was smart to just die ahead of time.
What? Did she say yes or no?
She puts up a post on Facebook to say that you know, you never came up from that wonderful proposal, so you could hear my answer yes a million times, but now you're dead.
Like, oh, wait,
that was the game. What? That was the game. I couldn't hold my breath long enough to tell you all the wonderful things I think about you.
So I'm gonna kill myself. So I'm like, it's something missing in this story that they're not telling. And exactly. So it's terrible journalism. The person that put the story out, hell with you. Cause you got a headline in the end. That's all you got. You were like, somebody drowned, dead. It's like you don't need to tell me what happened in the middle, because it don't make no sense. You went underwater on your own, won't nobody holding you down there, and you never come up. So somebody gave a theory, because this is one of the things I learned when I started scuba diving. You know that you can pass out from the pressure or whatever. Mm-hmm. If you come up too fast, they call it bends, and you can get out and you got this disease with air really getting in your lungs. So they're saying that possibly that he may have blacked out on the way up from coming up too fast. But I was like, how deep was he? Because that doesn't happen in 6 feet of water.
Thank you. You have to be super deep to have that. Like,
yeah.
You have to be
maybe he had a diving. Deep love for her.
He's dead. that's what happened.
He's conclusion.
Dead. He's dead.
He's dead.
And
I bet he won't do that no more.
He can't.
Too soon. Too soon.
But it's ridiculous, man. I didn't understand it. I was like, I'm confused by this entire story, and I'm really more mad at the journalists. I'm mad at the journalist because you didn't give us all the story. So now I'm invested in this story and I can't get it anymore. So I'm pissed off.
He mad at the journalist too.
He mad as hell. Yeah. But they had one of those, you know how you always see on Facebook in like Maldives or something where they had these bungalows out in the middle of the water and you got the water you can see through the floor. He had one of those. So I was like, is this ocean water? I really don't understand because it was an underwater room in this bungalow. So I don't know if he was in the ocean water. It would help for me because I'm frustrated because I don't know the whole story.
Yeah.
So.
But who helped him plan this? You know what I mean? Because that's a huge liability right there. Like,
damn.
Yes.
And then nobody tried to give him CPR. Or
what if this was her idea? That'd be worse. I
want to be proposed to underwater.
We met on a swimming trip. You proposed me underwater. This is terrible. Ladies, pick how you ask your men to propose to you. Hillary, will you marry?
Yeah, I remember that.
Stop it.
Classic.
So anyway, moving on. Today is the first day of fall, and it's 90-something degrees here in Atlanta. Facts. I don't know how the rest of y'all city is feeling, but I know that the whole East Coast is getting this heat wave, so... But the holidays are going to be coming in a couple of months, and Nestle launched a luxury Kit Kat. Mm. A luxury Kit Kat. It's a handcrafted version of the chocolate bar, and it's for the United Kingdom only. The way you can choose from 1,500 different flavors and personalize the package. And they're saying that it's quote unquote expensive. Now, how much is a Kit Kat now?
Like $3?
No.
What, the regular
that's
Kit Kat?
That's a Kit Kat.
Like $1.89?
$1?
Yeah, yeah. Roughly. Well, this one is going to be $17 per Kit Kat.
Not doing
so,
it.
That's expensive as hell for candy bar. But
is this a super-sized Kit Kat?
No, this is eight little balls.
You want to pay $17?
$17.
Nigga, that's gas.
It's a lot of things.
But you stuffing it.
It's a lot of things.
But you stuffing it with what you want it to be.
Right? Well, it's the different types of chocolate and flavor into it. So, that's...
So, no personal flavors. I got you.
Yeah, I guess you can make up a flavor.
You make my own sauce?
Can you make up your own sauce?
You want sauce to give it to?
I'm going to put up some pictures. I'm going to put up some pictures.
That reminds... You know what? I won't bring that up. Go ahead.
I'm just saying. I was totally frightened by what he might have said. Every time he do that, I'm scared.
It's along the same line. So, did you hear about the kids who had the bake sale? And they made their own personal sauce... In the cupcakes.
All right. We're going to go on a break. We got a break.
Them, listen, and they fed them to all the teachers.
We're going on a break. Secret sauce. We'll be back. IBNX Radio. ATL's Next 100.
IBNX Radio. ATL's Next 100.
Secret sauce. Hey, yo, cut my mic off. He cut his mic off.
This trip got you in heat. It's jumping, baby girl, hop on it. Yeah, you know that I'm on beat. All these trips got you feel. Those eyes I'm trying to love. Girl, I know that you ready. Girl, I'm not gonna let you down. I ain't gonna keep you waiting. If you bow it, it's gonna get knocked off. You playing hide and seek, I'ma find you. Baby, hold on tight. I need all that love on me. You like it what you see. Everything designer that's on me. That's why the when I walk, looking like you, just trying to. Yeah, this trip got you in heat. It's jumping, baby girl, hop on it. tell. You know that I'm gonna be. All these drip got you to me. All these drip got you in. Some whale well, juices running down her knee. No stylist in the saline. Got you flogging with an icy pedophilia. Pretty vibes inside a mansion by the beach. Get the prints all on your bathing suit, your stylist so you need. Show me beds inside your room, designer garments for the week. And that's all on me, I swear that's all on me. You acting like you really want it. You gon' get it. Once I you good, I got you. In your feelings. Perky bands and go your pouches. Got you dripping. Back and listen more accounts. Counting digits. Cherishing the riches. You liking what you see? Everything designer, that's on me. That's why the way I walk. Looking like you. Just trying to. Yeah. This trip got you in heat. It's jumping, baby girl. Hop on it. Yeah. You know that I'm on beat. But that's all up to you, yeah. I wanna get equal. All I ask is for my people. Baby, we gon' keep it simple. I need all that love on me. You like it what you see. Everything designer, that's on me. That's why the way I walk. Looking like you, just trying to, yeah. This trip got you in heat. It's jumping, baby, girl, hop on it.
Coming back. Welcome back.
Is that the Carter? Welcome back, Carter.
So, yeah, that was Heat from the Chris Brown Indigo
Classic. Tour.
Tour is going crazy. He's about to be here October
2nd.
Which is a Wednesday, I believe.
Yep.
Yeah. So
I'm taking cash apps now. Whoever wanna go.
I still wanna go. I kinda wanna go.
What?
Huh? Yeah. Ain't no kinda. Can we turn Jackson's mic on too?
Maybe he got him confused with Pedro.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah,
turn his mic off.
But the mic would be
turn the mic off. Turn his mic off.
Turn it off. Anyway, man, we got to get into it. Every day is a holiday. We want people to really celebrate and really enjoy themselves. So we talk about the holiday. So today's holiday is...
What is it, J-Boy?
This week's holidays, of course, is still Self-Improvement Month and National Chicken Month. I don't know why. I just want to keep telling y'all that as black people, we should not be celebrating this. Monday, today is first day of fall, as I told you. It's also National Checkers Day. National Checkers Day. Mm. Playing chestnut checkers, man. My mama is a checkers player. Anybody want to play checkers?
King me!
And my mama is like the sweetest person in the world. You talk to her and she all sweet. And she take care of you and all that. And then when checkers come out, she turned to this monster, yo. Yeah. My mama, you don't want to play games? She used to make us cry when we was little. Right. She'd talk to her. She ain't no mercy. And she laughed the whole time. She'd be jumping you and killing you. This is my mom.
So she now, do triple jumps and all that?
Yeah, everything. My mama's a vulture. anyway, so don't, if she asks you to play checkers or call out to anything.
I'll play chess.
Like, just tell her no.
I only do Connect Four.
I might get her a checkers necklace for Christmas. Cool. It's also, speaking of getting something for a lady, it's a proposal day. Speaking of proposals, it's proposal day. Moving on.
Don't drown.
No. Anybody got any cool ideas?
It doesn't have
ideas?
To be a marriage proposal.
No. It's definitely a proposal.
We're talking about
somebody.
Proposal.
No, it's not right. Proposal.
I propose that you give me the,
So as men, do y'all ever think about, because I think ladies, and this is my perception, the ladies have not told me this, but this is my perception that ladies kind of think about or they envision how they're going to be proposed to, if it's going to be public or dove's gonna fly, you gonna set itself on fire, whatever.
I told you what I always thought.
As men, do you have, so I'll come to you first.
Right.
As men, do you have ideas? And you gotta give your idea.
Nah, I just always thought a woman was gonna propose to me.
Oh.
And it happened.
Right?
But yeah, but I'm not gonna go into the story, but yeah.
That's growing up, that's what your thought. Mm-hmm. A woman's gonna propose.
Cause I feel like she knows what she wants. Go ahead and get it.
Jesus Christ. He's representing a segment.
But I'm old school, so I feel like I'm supposed to propose. And I think one time in my life, I did actually go through that step where I asked the father of the girl for her hand. So I actually did get that far.
You did it?
Yeah. I swear I told you.
You didn't tell me this.
I did tell you.
Why did I find this out on there?
I told you.
Exactly.
Tell this story.
I knew where this was going.
Hey, y'all talk about me?
I know what you're talking about now, but you didn't tell me this.
I did.
You done had surgery and everything else. You stopped.
But there was a reason why you didn't tell me that, though.
No, I know.
At the time. I know you hadn't. No, secrets.
No, you're the king of the secrets.
You didn't want to have surgery and everything else.
Yeah. Sure. No. You're like, I almost died this weekend. Yeah. No, Pedro. We talk every day. At what point did you about to die? We are talking constantly all day long.
Anyway. You was dying in the group chat? Tell us.
Right. That's some bullshit.
I'll try to change it.
No wonder it's taking you so long to respond.
That's what <Aaron. laughs>
I was in the water too long. I came up too fast.
Oh my God.
He sent back skeletons.
Okay, Jackson, how emojis. About you?
He came up, he said, I thought it was just a migraine.
Jackson.
You know what?
Did you grow up with that idea?
I honestly did not.
Like, we don't really think about it, right?
But for men don't. I think we so busy running from it for a good old while.
Yeah.
I'm not interested in that.
And then I have my opinion. Okay, Pedro, you actually did it. Was it on a whim?
You sure you did it? He just woke up married. Which y'all went to Vegas?
True, you were born married. They like, cut the umbilical cord. It's a ring on it.
It's a ring.
So if I would have waited longer, right? If I would have waited longer, I would have been like, yo, let's go to the courthouse. That's how I would have known if she a keeper.
If you had waited later on in life.
Later on in life.
But you didn't, right. So what did you do?
But since I didn't, I kind of did it like real smooth. Like I spoke to, you know, both her dads, and then I asked them, you know what I mean?
You got to clear that up, because that just, in 2019, that sounds like something
you
else.
You said both of her dads?
Yeah, like I had to ask her real daddy and her stepdaddy.
Okay, because in 2019, it sounded like
she
is raising.
Wait a minute.
My two dads?
Yeah, exactly.
Like, once again, king of secrets.
Wait a minute. Her dads are.
What? Hello, if you know you.
So then I was like, damn, like, what am I going to do? Like, I ain't think about, like, calling her sisters or calling my family and setting it up. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? It wasn't no videos of it out already, so it's kind of, you had to make it up on your own. So I took it to the beach, you know what I mean? And I kind of, like, gave her a poem.
You better not have wrote it in the sand.
Nah,
I can't.
Yeah,
you.
No.
All right, go ahead. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
So I just went out there, you feel me? And I was like, yo, like, I'm going to marry you.
And not like, will you marry me?
Nah, I said, I'm going to marry you.
Mm-hmm. And hey, girl.
I got that on one knee.
In the water?
At least you did that.
Yeah, nah.
Did you have on white linen pants? It sounds like some bullshit.
Nope. I had on some jeans and some Nikes. Yeah. And I was in the sand.
On the beach? Yeah, that sounds right. Yep. A ninja.
On the beach?
And
this is not how I see this at all, Pedro.
It was like, yo, like I got down on one knee. And it was weird because I was like, why is everybody at the beach today? Because there was a lot of people.
I'm trying to keep this a secret.
Like, damn, everybody here.
Everybody at the beach right now.
So then, like, I get down on one knee or whatever. I ask her. She say yes. But I ain't even hear her say yes because everybody was just clapping. And they was like, oh, my God, this is so beautiful.
And you creased your Nikes.
Yep,
the whole time you was thinking, I am creasing these Nikes down on this knee.
They're like, look, the broke guy with the BK Dykes is proposing.
Truth. He twisted his Nikes up. He must love her.
He must love her.
Destroy them Nikes.
Got to take one of them shoes off. Okay, hey, all right. So. Yeah. And she said yes.
Congratulations.
And he actually didn't hear it. Yeah. More of the story.
He was 12.
All right, so ladies, I'm telling y'all, we had that discussion, brief discussion, because we don't really be thinking about it. Y'all be having all these visions, and then when it's whack, it's not really our fault. Now, if he ain't never been creative in your entire relationship,
true.
Why are you expecting him to be creative on this?
It's the social media age. They want it to be filmed nowadays.
A lot of them. You can
they
hang
want
that
to be
up
planned, and you want the music and the doves, and they want to do a dance.
I think she probably writes it out for him, and he just performs.
That might be a good idea.
So that means you need to write in a plane. You got to jump out the plane, and you're when we let parachute up,
you
and say, "Will you marry me?"
I've heard women say the way he asked me wasn't good enough, so I said no.
Yeah, I've heard that too.
And it's like, hold on.
I hope they are single till they say.
That's why you gotta have people in front of you. Dude, so she won't say
you
no.
Took it. I'm like, hey, you deserve to be single for the rest of your life.
That's your life. I didn't like the way you get a terrible boyfriend after that too.
So is that why people do it in front of a lot of people so they won't say no?
Well, it's a lot of pressure.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it's an idea, but so, I think it's just.
I seen that live.
Hmm? Somebody say no live.
I feel so bad for
Didn't Joe Budden get, she said no in Times Square?
Times Square, but that's different.
No, it ain't different.
They did that for TV.
I don't know. She said no. It was bad. No, no one will forget that. Anyway, so also, it's Restless Legs Awareness Day. Some of y'all got restless legs. RLS is a restless leg syndrome. It's a real thing. sometimes you can't sleep. You ever been in bed? You just can't. Your legs can't ever get comfortable? You be moving too much? Maybe I just got too much energy. Moving on.
I've had that. You be running in your sleep?
Yes. It's called restless leg syndrome. Y'all ain't say, I be up late at night sometimes, and you see the infomercial called RLS. Are you suffering from RLS? Yes. I'm like, yes, I am. That is me.
Jason be laying on his back and his legs be...
yeah. Doggy paddling in, on dry land.
That J-Boy, sit still.
I can't. That's all this energy got to go somewhere. Anyway, Tuesday is Kiss Day. Kiss somebody in the mouth. National Punctuation Day. Yell at somebody. And National Cherries Jubilee Day. I don't know. What a Cherries Jubilee. Yeah, I guess it's a dish. I don't know.
Cherries Jubilee.
Not having it. And National Voter Registration Day on Tuesday. So if you're not registered, some of y'all been moving. You know, like us, this is the thing. One of the things you don't go get taken care of is to be like, am I voting my district? We'll drive across town back to where we used to live just to vote.
Oh, yeah.
I have voted downtown forever. I have moved 8 times. I still vote downtown.
Just the one I know.
For real. I know there ain't no line here, too. I just keep coming here. Wednesday, World Dream Day. So, you know, dream a little dream of me. Your dreams, stick with those. It is National Comic Book Day, too, on Wednesday. So, any comic book fans? Anybody? Nobody?
Oh, yeah, definitely me. Definitely.
All right.
Wolverine was one of my best ones.
National Lobster Day for all you bougie people out there. Which don't really make sense. But
lobster?
Yeah, they make people, they'd be like, I'm bougie. But you do know that people who have an EBT card can buy lobster. So, moving on.
I mean, I've always thought that. I just want to know why they consider all the bottom feeder food to be bougie.
Them roaches.
It's always backwards to me.
Yes, it's just backwards. It's like, this is high end. That's high like, end. You know this is trash, right?
It's
right.
Like the dirt. He's off the dirt.
These are the bugs feeder. Of the sea.
Yeah, exactly. It's the roaches of the sea.
Them and shrimp. But, you know, people, the high end. Make them squeal, put it in hot water. Thursday is Human Resources Professional Day. So, man, anybody you know to work at Human Resources, that girl you like to wear that little skirt that work in Human Resources, go ahead, man, give her a card. Don't touch her, though.
Don't do it at work,
get fired.
Don't give her a call at work and say, hey, what you doing?
No, oh, yeah, do because then you go and get workplace harassment.
Truth.
Yeah, so you can't even really enjoy that.
Truth.
Remember when it was the fly girl that worked in Human Resources? You'd be like, man.
I'm gonna tell you how you do it. I want to give you my human resources.
But that's stupid, because she can get you fired out of there quicker.
I'm gonna tell you how you do
it. She know all the rules.
What? You take a card.
That's why you make friends.
Right? You say, hey, I really like you, but I can't talk to you. And you put your number on her windshield. And then when she see it, she gonna decide when she drive away whether or not she gonna call you.
Pedro is still, you like me, yes or no?
Yeah,
box.
Right.
That's what happens when you get married at the age of 14.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
You still got the same game. You still got the same game.
That shit worked.
Pedro's still doing a yes, no, maybe.
He still got the same game
from
when he was when he was born.
Check the box. Women like that.
Oh, he's so cute.
I don't know.
He's a child.
Did you hear how much he believed that?
Yeah.
Women like that.
I mean, I don't know.
Girls like that.
I do it to my wife all the time.
Oh, yeah. whatever's first on that list. Whatever's next on that list, go ahead. Hula, whatever you got. Nothing? You pick. As long as it's clean. Friday, Ancestor Appreciation Day, man.
Oh, nice.
Why I brought up that one? Because I do want to do the Ancestry.com. And some of the, I think it's some bullshit in it. But I want to kind of follow the tree. I know some of you may have done it before, but I know.
I got to 1800.
Where? Mm-hmm. That's dope. Like
1800.
Yeah, and a lot of birth certificates said NEG. And for Dick,
negative.
But the crazy thing is, one of my grandparents, her mom was like Blackfoot Indian. Mm. So they didn't even.
Which were
African. They put us all under NEG, which is crazy.
Yeah. Negative.
So yeah, man, I want to do that because it's a lot that I don't know. You know what I'm saying? And you'd be like, man.
But like, I wonder, like, do you have to be like 5th or 6th, like U.S.
generational?
You know what I mean? Because it's like,
because there's a lot of records not there.
Right, it's a lot of records that's like
not there. I just want to see where it stopped. Like, my dad, his mom died when he was 16, and he don't know his dad. So it's like, it's a lot over there that I don't know at all. You know what I'm saying? So
because my tree just won if I do it in the U.S.
It won, it's a leaf.
Like one.
It's a branch on the ground.
It's a branch.
It's a rotten
It's a seed.
You got between one leaf.
It's one.
Hanging.
And that's me.
You first generation.
I'm first generation.
Oh, wow. Yeah. So he's like, I can't trace nothing.
You got that wilted leaf.
It's also Hug a Vegetarian Day. Word. So I don't know if Pedro gets a hug because he's vegan. No gas.
Ladies.
No gas. Hug a Vegetarian Day. Love note day for y'all to still write love notes, Pedro.
I told you it worked.
I told you it worked. It's his week. National Bakery Day. Shout out to Cakes by Pat.
He be caking. He be caking.
I be caking.
National Chocolate Milk Day.
I love chocolate milk.
And it's Native American Day.
Hove.
True.
So yeah, man, that was a little lengthy, but I mean, I wanted to give you, I'd like to give y'all the holidays for the week because my sister works in human resources. I hit her. I was like, "Yo, you know Thursday is not as human resources."
I thought it was Wednesday.
Human resource professional day, and she was like, "She said that's awesome. Thanks for telling me. What should I do?"
I was like, "I don't know, Morgan. You figure everybody out when you go to work so they can celebrate you."
Yeah, buy yourself a card and balloons.
Like, put a dollar on your shirt.
Something. But yeah, human resource man is one of those. It's a whole group of African American. It's a group that you can join. You know, African American human resource professionals, and so they actually had a conference down here.
Is it safe?
I don't know.
It ain't safe.
Is it safe? It ain't safe.
It ain't safe. But speaking of safe, it's a safe time to take a break. We're gonna do that right now. IBN Next Radio, ATL's Next 100.
I had to get.
Make memes. I'm on a money routine. I don't want smoke, I want cream. I don't want no more comparisons. This is a marathon, and I'm aware I've been playing a bet from a lack of promotions. I never was one for the bragging and boasting. I guess I was hoping the music would speak for itself, but the people want everything else. Okay,
no problem. I show up on every one album. You know what the outcome will be. I'm betting 1,000. It's got to the point that these rappers don't even like rapping with me. Come on, 21 Savage just hit me and told me he sent me a spot on a new record he got. He called it a lot. I open my book and I jot. Paper Tekashi, they wanting a rap. I picture him inside a cell on a cot, reflecting on how he made it to the top, wondering if it was worth it or not. I pray for Markel cause they love a shot. Just want you to know that you got it, my nigga. Though I never met you, I know that you special. When that the Lord bless you, don't doubt it, my nigga. Dennis Majunior, stay solid, my nigga. I'm on a tangent, not how I planned it. I had some fans that hopped in a band and shit when they thought that I wasn't gon' pan. Now I got a plan. They say the success is the greater revenge. Tell all your friends, call on a mission. Submitting the spot is the greatest that did it before it all ends.
How much money you got? A lot. How many problems you got? A lot. How many people done doubted you?
A lot.
Left you out to rot?
A lot.
How many pray that you flock?
A lot.
How many lawyers you got?
A lot.
How many times you got shot?
A lot.
How many you shot?
A lot.
How many times did you ride?
A lot.
How many done die?
A lot.
How many times did you cheat?
A lot.
How many times did you lie?
A lot.
How many times did she leave?
A lot.
How many times did she cry?
A lot.
How many chances she done gave you? Run with these thighs.
Jam. That was a lot. What we called it? That was an engineer selection, engineer's choice. We used to have that. Remember when what was Young Boy's name?
21
Savage. Aaron. No, yeah.
Aaron. Yeah. Blacksmith.
Yeah, I forgot his name. See what happened? That's his fault.
That's his fault.
Man, his fault. Hey man, I meet a lot of people and talk to a lot of people. I purge you. you delete yourself from my life. That's on you.
Damn. So, he just got another job,
J-Boy. Did you?
You left. I deleted you.
J-Boy saw a good future.
Nah.
That's all. He put a lot of quality time into that man.
Facts.
Well, he said blacksmith, he was sharpening him.
You know.
You want a return on your investment.
It's something.
He like Suge.
Tell me what's up. Yeah, don't.
You should have hung him over the balcony. You know,
hey, don't be my son. But anyway, moving on. People say and do stupid stuff all the time.
So we just did.
All we like to talk about is our favorite part of the show. It's called
That's Stupid.
So what you got for me today?
Now, first of all, all my guys here have been pulled over at least once, right?
Yes.
Now, when you get pulled over and the cop asks you, do you know why I pulled you over?
Yeah.
I don't know, but please finish.
You don't tell the cop, you don't know who I am.
Oh, yeah, no.
Well, this WWE superstar lady, her name is Lacey Evans, told an officer in Canada.
Them Laceys.
Do you know who I am? The officer said, no, ma'am, but you have a ticket. You know? And she was really, like, disrespectful and kind of mad that he wasn't in a good mood. But I'm like, you lucky he didn't shoot you. We have to worry about getting shot. And we can't really argue with a cop.
That escalated quickly.
But she in Canada, though.
I'm just saying, bro.
She worried about.
The most she can get in Canada is hit with a stick. Canadians nah, don't shoot.
But I'm just saying the privilege. She was able to be comfortable and yelling at this officer about a ticket. Oh, yeah. And she snatched it out of his hand like, you don't know who I am?
You're very right. And she didn't die.
She didn't die.
Well, I'm more mad. I don't know if I'm more mad. I think I'm more mad.
In Canada.
Oh, because you get hit with a stick. Got it.
Come on. I'm just saying.
But it's the principle that when your cop pulls you over, you're like, all right, this can go south. You never know how bad that this can go.
Man, and the I don't fact even talk
that,
about it.
Like we, and I'm like, we don't have the audacity to have that conversation.
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm lying. We do. At least I did.
In America. I ain't saying nothing. Yeah. I'm black.
Like, yes, sir.
I'm bald-headed. Nope. Dark skin and bearded. I'm all the suspects.
Not in Canada.
You look like 1, 2, 5, and 8.
For real. I am the 1, 2, lineup.
1, 2, 5, 7. Yeah, okay. Got you.
Which one is it, ma'am? 1, 2, 3. Yeah, I'm all of them.
Not in Canada. Right. Drake is the president. Come on.
It might be furthermore in Canada. I don't know. But anyway. Right. So, this, the stupid goes to the system because it allows it to happen, number one. And stupid does go to, that's just her privilege.
Yeah, her privilege.
That's why she wasn't, that's why she did it. So to the system for being the way it is and treating us the way they treat us. Mm-hmm. And I be scared and shivering and mad and want to shoot all at the same time. I be all of those things at one time. And I'm all the suspects because I'm black and I'm bald headed and I'm
straight
bearded.
Up.
From us to you, that's stupid.
Moving on. Now, one thing, back in the day, are y'all old enough that people used to smoke in buildings? Are y'all old enough? I don't think you're old enough.
Nope.
Jason, you're old enough.
I don't know.
Where they used to smoke in the airport.
You old enough, Jason. You know.
Well.
You know.
Yeah, dang.
People still smoke in the airport, though.
Well, this restaurant manager took it upon himself. A customer actually was smoking near one of his tables, and he decided to take an extinguisher and spray the man.
Okay, that's excessive.
What?
Like sprayed his cigarette out with an extinguisher.
That's actually kind of funny. That's
kind of funny. In my mind, I'm like, he went through the process of popping the pin and all, aiming.
It's been a lot of smoking because they just landed a plane last week, too, because the dude he lit up a J on the plane.
Mm-hmm.
And they landed the plane. It's like, dog, you crazy. You don't light up on a plane?
Mm-hmm. He said, you don't know who I am?
You know?
So he pulled out the extinguisher. He lit up. He's in the airport. He like, man, I'm going to do what I want to do. He pulled it out, and somebody said,
no.
Got it. And they found an extinguisher. Shout out to the man knowing how to use the extinguisher. Yeah. It's the people that wouldn't even know how to pull the pin.
True.
Terrible.
And so you got sprayed, and you deserve it.
You got sprayed.
You got sprayed. Right. From us to you.
That's stupid.
What did she got for me?
Now, last but not least, I love car washes. Okay. You know, I like to go through them all the time. I even like to play good music.
You're going to really have to explain that.
All right, the auto car wash that you actually sit and you go through.
And just chill,
and chill. Yeah. It's like a good silence and you hear
that. I'm a child. That's how I used to like to go through that as a kid. Like, oh, we in the dark.
Right. But this particular family forgot.
To roll the windows up?
No.
Something
like that. But they forgot that the roof is on
fire. Huh?
Now, the roof has some holes in it. So as they're riding through the car wash.
Wait, not the rag top. It actually had holes in it.
Yeah, like the roof has some holes in it. What? So as like they was riding through.
Like air holes when you catch fireflies.
Yeah.
And bugs. And
so calipers. Like when they were riding through.
Like hail damage?
It was like a flood. The water was coming down.
How big was the holes?
it was coming from all over the place. So it was crazy.
I can't believe it.
But so they end up getting washed in the car wash.
So they forgot that you ain't got a whole roof and went to the car wash.
Car ain't had no roof.
They had to be literally. They had to be the highest. Did
they do like deluxe?
And it was an older lady, Caucasian lady, and her son.
It had to be like something crucial.
And it was sad because you could see the son like
You could see the son coming in.
No, the son, the actual little boy.
Oh, it got.
He said, "Well, we all need a shower." Did they do the wax and they wash too? I wonder if they got the full on wash. Like, was it the basic or did they do the deluxe?
I'm just glad they survived.
I figured it out. Grandma was trying to teach the son how to propose.
Underwater.
And it comes back. From us to you.
That's stupid.
Yeah, man, you see something stupid, you hear something stupid, tell us about it. JCSquaredLife@gmail.com. Make sure y'all send it over to us because people are doing stupid stuff
all the time.
Place. Hey, man, so. It's a good time to, yeah, I can do that now. I usually give y'all a list. I don't know if I got the list.
Got J-Boy's list today?
I don't know if I got it with me, though. I have one.
Where's the list?
We
need the list.
Word. So, yeah, it's J-Boy's list. From J-Boy's list today.
I don't see the
list. I don't know if y'all heard about, damn it.
What's wrong with him? Yeah.
About the list. Heard about the list.
Y'all heard about that? The Amazon group. Everybody's all hyped about the Amazon deals group and people's like spending more money on. They're like, man, I'm addicted to this group. Y'all heard?
Oh, I thought we were talking about women.
No, it's an Amazon deals group on Facebook. A lot of people are in there. A lot of people are talking about it. And one of our friends, she showed a picture of like 10 packages on her porch. Like, I'm addicted. Somebody please kick me out of this group.
Oh, you mean
I have heard about that.
Add me to that. I need that.
Price. Yeah.
No. Not deals. Like, they invest in things.
No.
Add me to that.
I need that. Bro, so, add me.
So basically,
this is the addiction I want.
Basically, she's couponing on Amazon.
Basically. Amazon doing another. They're again cornering the market. It's just another way to do it. Like, hey, Facebook deals, put it up. So the five best Amazon deals you can get today.
Let me put this in my notes.
If I can get it to scroll. Today, lowest price, number one is the lowest price on your favorite personal blender on the Ninja. They got a deal on the blender. I think you can get a Ninja for $39
today.
$39. It's usually $50.
Okay.
So it's a little deal on that. Under 40, a powerful portable charger.
I was about to say, anything I'm going to use?
Yeah. They got a portable charger, the Anker Power Core. I don't need 10,000 PD portable charger for $34. It's usually $40-something. So that's it. That's one of the best deals.
About an $8 difference.
Yeah.
Then you get a 20% promo code. Ooh, ooh.
So you save $11. I don't know about the promo code. I need to. I don't even know what this is. Aquaphor healing ointment. I don't think we need this.
The way his heart beat.
But it was to heal your chapped skin.
Chapped skin.
So you're not just your lips. Chapped skin. I don't think this is really for our community, but 14-ounce jar for $11. Now the
can
best...
you do massages with that?
With your chapped lip. girl, your booty little chap. Let me rub it. I got this Aquaphor. I need to try.
All 11
on
ounces.
Your chap booty.
All 14.
Anybody describe your ass as chap?
Chap.
Remember? Chaps. The clothes chap.
You got chap booties. Anyway, $40 off the best Kindle on the market.
Kindle.
They got a Kindle out there.
Okay. Oh, okay.
So a deal on a Kindle.
$12.
The best.
We should guess the price.
Price is right.
It says $25 off if you're a Prime member.
So I got Prime.
I'm happy you brought that up.
So it's like save $40 plus maybe extra $25. Right now you can get it for $89.
So Prime. So like if you have a friend or if you're a parent and you have a child that's in college, right? If you use their email, you can get Prime for like $5 a month. So you save.
I still got my college
so you
email.
Save $60. So you save $40.
Yeah.
Okay. Anybody? Hey, let me borrow some kids. Yeah. Anybody got some babies, Sonny?
Anybody got any social security numbers for your little kids, too? Yeah. Tax season coming.
Jesus. That's a crime. Number five.
Not the views.
For real. Up to 40% off K-Cups for your Keurig. So you get up to 40% off the K-Cup pods and coffee pods. So that's number five. So it's a bunch of deals up there, man. You keep it in your favorites. You can find some deals. I don't know if you can use it. But you know the inventor of the K-Cup says he wish he never invented them.
After he counted his money, though.
Yeah.
But because of the environment.
Yep. Because they don't go anywhere.
Biodegradable.
They are not. So he's like, I wish I never invented these things. Because now they're popular and they're not going anywhere ever. Save the whales. So anyway.
Save the whales.
What about the sea turtles, J-Boy? The babies. No, damn the babies. So anyway. I said that we would be the first generation of 30-plus-year-olds that wore Jordans and sweatsuits. And I was right.
Yep.
So here we go. Today in hip hop, man. This should be a national holiday. Today in hip hop, the supergroup Outkast released Speaker Box. Outkast, they released their fifth album, Speaker Box / The Love Below. That's some are considered Andre's solo album.
Wow.
I don't know if we can count that. But it came out September 23rd, 2003. Mm-hmm. That's right, 2003, man. And that album went diamond, I believe. That was the album that went diamond. Wow. Was it Equimini? Which one went diamond? I thought this went diamond.
That's actually today.
Shut up. So diamond, so for y'all that don't know, platinum is a million records.
Yeah. Diamond,
gold is 500,000 records.
Right.
Diamond is 10 million records.
Not so many people hit that, man.
Not a lot of people go diamond.
50 hit it. Eminem.
And these young boys out of from East Point.
Wow. Equimini was a dope record.
Tyler Park, East Point.
So I don't know which one. I think it might have been. I seen the plaque. I can't remember which one it is, though. But anyway.
It's Equimini.
It is Equimini?
I just saw the plaque 2 weeks ago. It's Equimini.
Okay. All right. Because it's in Tree Sound.
It is in Tree Sound. Yeah. Yes. It is Equimini.
So anyway, we're going to take a little break. We're going to play this song right here.
You turned off your mic. Turn off.
Find a way. place to be.
In the place to be and not to be at the same time.
Man, that was Speaker Box. Ghetto Music off the Speaker Box. Love Below record, man. Today in Hip Hop, September 23rd, 2003. Huge influence to hip hop. And to speaking of hip hop, man.
Yep.
Speaking of rappers, artists, people who speak into microphones in rhyming words on beats. we got a guest in here today, man. First time on the show with us. Y'all give it up for a man. Ace Red. Y'all give
chill,
it up for him. Get him,
chill,
get him, get him. Man, welcome to the show. Welcome to the show, bro.
Thank you.
Ace Red came in here representing the U with the Miami hat on. My man Pedro is from Miami. You are leaning into the camera, Pedro. Pedro is from Miami. I think he just likes the hat. And he likes apple juice. My man came in here with a gallon of apple juice. That is his thing, so it's going to be on the next cover of the next mixtape.
He just stamped that too. That's official.
It's official.
Apple juice.
No, on the cover of the next mixtape. Next mixtape is called Gallon of Apple Juice. I feel like hip hop is there now, though. I feel like you can just name it whatever. Mm. The covers could be anything now.
It's about clout now.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you ain't even got to rap on beat. It works.
Right. Yeah, so that's what I'm saying. So you can get on your artistic and be like, yo, what does a gallon of apple juice mean? And you'd be like, all right, you can just break it down.
A.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
It could be exactly.
Hey, that's hard though. You can use that. You know what I mean?
For real, man. I'm telling you.
He's sabotage.
Hey, Pedro, can anybody hear you? Here I'm.
Yeah, why are you leaning back?
No, get in them. You still here?
I'm still here.
Yeah.
Oh, my
yeah.
Man. This
is Pedro took a whole break. He on the bench. Pedro's like, I'm gonna get on the bench.
Like that. Hey, yelling from the back like drunk uncle. What's in that somewhere?
He's like, yeah.
My man. Like, who is that ninja in the background? Anyway, so, brother, where you from, though?
I'm from Atlanta, well, Riverdale, you know what I mean?
Okay.
Clayco. I'm familiar.
Do you feel that, cause I noticed you corrected that, right?
Yeah.
Do you feel like because you're from here, you feel the need to, you had to be very specific about that? Because people, yeah, like, he ain't from Atlanta. You feel like it's going to be that kind of crap? Or is it because you run and represent your area? Which one is it?
It's a little both, but at the same time, everybody gonna say, man, nah, Brain from the A, he really from Clayco. You know what I mean?
Doesn't it seem a little ridiculous?
When we leave the state,
it's from Atlanta. It's from Atlanta, you feel
exactly.
Me?
And I just think that's ridiculous, personally. Now, I do know that there are people in Riverdale who never been to the next exit. So,
that's true.
Or people on the east side that don't come to the south. Like,
for real?
I heard that the Amigos are from Lawrenceville.
Nah, they from the north.
They're all up here.
I don't know if it's specifically Lawrenceville, though. But you know what I mean? Them boys from the north. Nah, it's not Atlanta, but them boys claimed Atlanta. You feel me?
All day long, and yeah. And
cause nobody knows the mentioned Forest Park in some songs.
I just think that we black people, us, we tend to try to find divisions in things.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I don't think it's all our fault, but I think people in general, we try to find these divisions, and we don't need to do it. You know that's what I'm saying? Like, support you from the A.
Yeah.
that's what it is to us. And maybe they're saying, because you ain't from Atlanta, that's why you saying that. But I don't know. But you from that side, you're from the A, you represent the A, you got a new project out. What's the name of the new project?
No Handouts 2.
No Handouts 2. What does that mean?
It's basically, man, just what
this
I stand for.
This ain't the first one. No handout. This is
part two. This is second.
I mean this. No hands out for real.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
You
getting under my apple juice.
It's coming from the ground up. You know what I mean? We ain't have the handouts. We ain't really had the OGs to push this. You know what I mean? Mm. So we doing this from the ground up. No handouts.
What's your industry age?
My industry age.
Yes, because you know everybody. You know, you can't ask an artist or an actor really how old they are. Right. You ask them with their industry age. You just give me a number. It don't even matter if it's your real age or not. We don't know.
Let me see, 28.
All right, industry age. The reason I asked it because you said no OGs, and that's one of the things I feel like. There's a generation that doesn't have OGs.
Fact.
Like the generation now, we grew up with OGs.
Right.
I feel like y'all just kind of figuring it out.
And we slick turning to the OGs though.
Yeah, at 28, you definitely OG. Which is
OG.
Crazy.
It's crazy.
But if you didn't have an OG, you're like, all right, what's the rules?
And you don't got the guidance.
Correct.
Yeah.
Correct.
Yeah.
Okay. And I do think that has a direct impact on a lot of us. And I think that's why we got this generation of depressed kids. Because they ain't nobody had no OG.
Hey, social media got a lot to do with that, though.
Yeah?
So, yeah, I mean, you sit at home and you looking at social media, you seeing your favorite rapper. Are you seeing everybody winning, which that's what Instagram is, because ain't nobody posting their losses for real. You know what I mean? So you sit around and you get entwined to that. You like, damn, I ain't doing this. I ain't going here and posting this picture here.
I ain't
seeing
going to
this.
That event.
Yeah, you know what I mean? And that caused a lot of depression, man. They got to get out of that, though.
Ace Red just stamped something. We now posting our losses. For the rest of 19, we posting our losses.
Yeah.
I lost yesterday. And then it make the win seem bigger.
It do.
Transparency.
For real. But so no handouts too. What you trying to do with this project? What do you want people to feel when they listen to your music?
It's a compilation, man. Like I say, it's really the grind of the outcome of this South rapper who really ain't had a handouts. We did this strictly independent. And everybody say they're independent. Nah, you ain't independent. You got somebody over here who pushing it or whatever like that. We really independent. We doing this ourselves, you know what I mean?
Spending your own money.
That's it.
Wait, you look like you do push-ups and slap people on the side. Is this real or your shirt just small? Which one is
it? I do. It might be both. You know what I mean? It might be a little bit both, but I'm definitely in that gym again.
Okay,
man.
That's what's up. Did you play ball?
I played college ball.
Play college ball? Who would you play for?
Virginia Union.
Hey,
Richmond.
Yeah.
Now I like you even more, sir.
Yeah,
you should have started with that. Start with that. Everything. I'm an Ace Red fan.
Tell him what your name is.
Now. I'm Jason 804. Now I'm from Richmond.
Oh,
I'm a Richmond boy for sure.
Okay. Cool.
You might have played with my brother-in-law, but I will talk about that later.
Okay.
So Virginia Union just pushing out rappers because Fresher played for Virginia Union too.
Who?
Fresher.
I want to say it sound familiar, but I don't know Holmes.
Fresher from New York. He played for Virginia Union as well. So
that's crazy.
Shout out to Union. Shout out to Union. You can play ball and rap. And this is a seminary school.
Yeah.
Where they got pastors.
No cap.
The irony.
Shondo.
Yeah.
What?
Shata.
Anyway, no football players, no handouts too, man. Are you performing anywhere locally? Are you?
Yeah, we got A3C coming up.
He about to hit that apple juice, y'all,
man.
On camera. He about to hit that apple juice.
Go.
So y'all, you about to hit A3C? Want people come out there and get it? How do they get the street
you can check
album?
Me out. You can check me out on Instagram, underscore Ace Red with 2 D's.
Your name already spelled funny. Why you need the underscore? Ace Red was taken?
It was. You know, I actually used it when I was younger. Ah. And I messed up the profile, and it was always just taken.
You need to hit them directly and be like, listen, I'm tired of this underscore. That other Ace Red is me, too. Just get to it.
Just get to
it. I might need to do that. You are.
Yeah, because it's easier, because I forgot where the underscore at already. Where is it at?
It's in the beginning.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Right. Remember, and it's Ace Red with two D's.
Yeah.
Ace Red. What? Like why Ace Red?
My real name is, my last name is Red.
Okay.
With two D's, you know.
That's
what I mean?
Dope. So you set up to be something. Rap, ball player, or something. The Red is, that is dope, man. So A3C, when is that?
October, when is A3C? What dates? They got a conference this year. It's like a whole week long thing this year.
It's a week long now.
Yeah.
I remember it from the infancy to now. So it's dope that it has grown to be a highly respected music conference during that week. So it's a lot of artists come through there for that particular event. So, hey man, make sure y'all go out there and check that out. Follow them on social media. Go get the record. What's the main single off this? What's the mixtape?
We gonna put Splash, man. I mean, we ain't got time out. We got a video on that on YouTube, but I think we're going to put Splash. The people are more receptive to Splash.
Splash. Yeah. What's the feel of Splash? First day of fall, that sounds like a summer song. What's Splash?
You know, Splash is actually a summer song. I would put in my perspective, when I hear it, it's like a pool party, like a real live lit pool party. You know what I mean?
So it's 90 degrees, 95 degrees in the south on the first day of fall. So we still getting in the pool. Yeah. So y'all can still play Splash.
Yeah, sure.
Facts. Yeah. I still want y'all to go out there and rock Splash, man. Man, hey, tell them again what the social media is. Tell them how they find you, what you got going on, what else you got going on.
I am _ Ace Red on everything. Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat. We just dropped No Handouts 2.
Mm-hmm.
It's on all platforms, Spotify, Tidal, Apple Music. We got a video coming out. We about to shoot Splash. We got
everybody invited.
Up. Everybody invited. Come on.
I just put that out there. I just invited somebody to somebody.
Pull up.
Hey, what's the best thing about being an MC right now? MC, being a rapper, whatever you would call yourself. What's the best thing about being
an MC? For me, man, it's the music is just like a way to express, just let it all out for real. For me, a lot of cats don't do it for that though. A lot of cats just want the shine or want blase, all the females, all the attention. You feel me?
Yeah.
For me, it's just more about pushing what I feel out.
Do you want to do anything other than rhyme?
Yeah.
What's next? You want to act? Okay.
Yeah. My little cousin, I don't know. Hey, shout out to Isaiah John, man. Y'all watch Snowfall? He Leon.
That's your cousin?
That's my blood cousin, my little cousin.
Yeah. Like, y'all know each other, y'all friends. Like.
That's my cousin. Yeah.
You know what I mean? Be like, that's my cousin. We ain't talking like 30 years, but that's my cousin.
We talked about the acting, man, and bro just so hard on the show. I don't know if y'all
he go
in.
I fool with him hard.
Bro, I gotta start watching.
I actually binge watched Snowfall on Sunday.
Man, it's crazy.
Season 1, and I'm like half in on season 2.
Yeah.
And Leon, he funny.
I love Leon. And he thorough, though.
He thorough.
Now, he fell in love with the little crackhead, though.
Don't ruin that. I ain't watching it yet.
Okay.
You one of them. Don't turn it
down. I had issues with that.
I'll never watch it.
I ain't get there yet, so I appreciate it.
Oh, yeah, you'll find out. Give a damn about your life.
Your life.
Y'all 3 years late, man.
True. You're right, though. True.
You deserve it.
That's like Power. You saw Power last night?
No.
I can tell you who died in that.
I know.
I ruined that for you.
All right.
Everybody watching Power, though. I like Power, bro. Yeah. But I feel like Snowfall is better.
Snowfall is a...
I might be biased, too, though.
No, you're not.
Yeah, okay.
It's different. It's the same story on different coasts, kind of.
Yeah,
a little bit, you know what I mean?
True. Right.
And so the energy
and
is a lot
younger
different.
Too, so you kind of feel it.
Yeah.
So they a lot stupider.
Right.
Yeah. In the beginning, they was stupid.
They just
didn't know what they just fell into it. So, but it's I thought it was loosely based on and
Freeway.
You guys your cousin Freeway. Yeah.
I
thought it was loosely based on.
And we had him on the show. Before T.I. did.
Y'all had him on the show.
Yeah.
That's dope.
Yeah. So you on an official platform. She don't bring you to no bullshit.
Okay, you locked in.
Yeah, we official up here, man. So anyway, make sure you go out and get that Ace Red, man. He's expressing himself on this. It's No Handouts 2.
Chill.
Go get the record. Go wherever you can see him perform. Make sure you follow him. Follow him on the gram and see where he's at, man. I believe he got a good personality, man. So I believe he's a man of the people. He gonna go out there and hang. Some people come up here and they're terrible interviews.
Yeah.
So it's a lot of on rappers that are terrible interviews, man.
It's because they need apple juice.
That's what it is.
True.
Apple juice is the
same.
It's about the apple juice,
man. If he got it, hey, he got a t-shirt. You gonna have a t-shirt with a bottle of apple juice?
Apple juice. Yes,
we gotta drink the apple juice.
Yeah, you got to. I'm in there.
Just juice.
I'm in there. Hey, man, we're going to take a little break. We'll take a little break, and we'll be back right here on IBNX Radio. We got to talk about
something. Hello, Swainy. Being with you is like a trip on ecstasy. Without being physical, it's like nothing I've ever felt before. I just landed, and I'm thinking of you. I wrote this about our day. Cada fuego que enciendo. Enciendo por ti, mis ojos rojos grandes, mis ojos cafés azules. Bajo luces de túneles con vista al mar, tus besos dulces en mi mente tú.
Another record in there too for you. There's another record. So hey man, we talked about, I had a segue into what I'm gonna talk about, but I can't remember what it is, so forget it.
Watch your
mind. So this past week, I said forget it. So this past weekend, and Pedro, I couldn't wait to have this conversation with you. Dinner en Blanc was this weekend, right?
Yes, mm-hmm. It was.
And I have my feeling and
Did Pedro go?
On it.
No.
For those who don't know what it is. Mm-hmm. I'll give you the, I guess, the internet version of it, and we'll get into it. Worldwide event spanning 6 continents in which people have a meal dressed in white in a temporary dining setup in a public space. Diners are required to provide their own food, tables, chairs, and tablecloths. Only a select number of participants who have previously signed up are made privy to the location the day of the dinner and generally converge in an iconic urban location. This past weekend, it was in Centennial Park, right, with the
Ferris wheel in the background
and all that. It started in Paris in 1988. Francois Pasquier invited a group of friends to an elegant outdoor dinner at the at this place, asking them to dress in white so they could find each other. The event's presence has grown to over 85 cities, with almost 17,000 gathering for the 30th anniversary event in Paris. Which sounds cool.
It's a dope event.
So
I want to know if he asked his friends to bring these fold up tables and chairs.
Not.
I don't understand this.
So watching on Facebook, you see people with their wagons and their tables and getting everybody got on MARTA. They had this little MARTA card.
Yep.
And you get on MARTA before you would go to this location. They would bus people in, and kind of sound like a picnic I could have planned.
My biggest thing
a
is
a little bit, see, my, but. This is not my problem with it. Go ahead. You got something to say?
No, go ahead. So,
my challenge with it, I got 2 sides to this.
Okay.
So I titled this "Dinner on Block: My Position First, Where the Joy Should Be."
Okay.
That's what I titled it. My problem with it is the perception of class, the elitism thought process behind some of the people that go.
Mm-hmm. It's true.
It ain't exclusive if everybody can go. Mm-hmm. It was all up and down my timeline. I knew everybody there.
Yeah. Well, no. But you are missing a key point, though.
We'll get to that.
Okay, go ahead.
I'm still mad that they got on white carrying stuff. This is my problem.
And there's this feeling of people that want to be included in something. That they've never been in a group, never been in a clan. They'd be like, well, I'm going to such and such. And your nose is up in the air, and I'm like, nigga, you went to a picnic. Stop it.
You brought your own hot dogs and chips.
Stop it. Nice of it. I love a good party or whatever. Mm-hmm. Us, as for those who don't understand black culture, we love a white party, apparently. You tell them, no matter where they're going, it's a white party. They buy up everything white in the mall.
Yeah.
They can't wait. You should see it when it gets spring here in Atlanta. Every store got a white display in the front of the store. Before you even get to the expensive stuff, it's just cheap white pants everywhere. welcome to the A. So, and some of the outfits are terrible. But just looking at it, I see this sense of, it's some pompousness in it that it doesn't belong to me. That's my position. It doesn't belong. You spent this money. I carried all my stuff, and I had a picnic in the park with some people I don't know, and I spent the whole time taking pictures. I didn't even enjoy the party. I spent the whole time selfieing and not really enjoying the party. You know what I'm saying? So all the issues I have with today's parties is wrapped up.
Who's the DJ?
In this one.
Anybody who know?
G Nice DJ, I think, this week. I saw him. Yeah, I think he DJ. I don't know if he was DJ the whole time, but he definitely DJ. So, that's my position.
That's my position.
That's one part of my position. I will argue the other side in a minute, but go ahead.
I'm going to go last. Go ahead, Jackson.
You said your thing about it.
No, I'm just the commentator over here that's not, like, my eyebrows are not lifted about this, because to me, it's more work than. I definitely feel that. Yeah, I could have taken these same pictures on a night out of the town with a whole bunch of strangers.
And it's Atlanta. And in August or September, and it's hot.
And I didn't have to bring the food.
And everybody's wearing pants. It's hot. I'm going outside. It's hot. And I'm partying.
Then you got barbecue sauce on the bottom of your jeans.
And it's hot.
Man, ketchup.
I see somebody had the mosquito net over their table. They had the white mosquito net on their. It was a veil on their table. I was like, I can see you.
I do. You lift it up.
Exactly. You want some chicken? I do. So
I can see you. You're not hiding.
So Pedro, go ahead, because. That's one side, and I want you to argue to that side. I'll get to the where the joy should be.
All right, so I'm gonna cover all of your points.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so it is an exclusive party. So what happens is you can only go if you were invited, right? And what happens is, so for instance, if I invite you, J Boy, right? You my one guest.
17,000 people. That's not exclusive.
It is though. You gotta remember, it's like 8 million people in the city. So listen. So.
Mm-hmm.
you my guest, uh-huh. right? Now, say you invite Hov, mm-hmm. right? Hov has to wait until next year until he can go.
And right? there's 80,000 people
so
waiting.
So that's all it takes for right. us to get in?
Uh-huh. And there's a waiting list, right? So that's the allure of the exclusivity of this event.
Oh, I finally got invited to a party.
Truth.
Face.
What are we, 16?
Nah. But you got to work like you're hosting it.
Truth. True.
Exactly.
Right. True, because you got to bring everything.
Right. And I would be entertaining the entire table. This would be work. This is what I'm saying.
For free.
All work. All work. Uh-huh. Then, okay, people try to outshine each table. So they bring these decorations. Now, I'm not going to lie. These decorations be like, yo, they spent a lot of money or a lot of time.
Almost like a Mardi Gras.
Putting these.
Which I'm going to get to.
Putting these props together, right?
Didn't know.
And I never understood that part, but then now I kind of get it because it's like their expression of what Paris should be. So in this setting,
they ain't thinking about Paris though, dog. Wait, listen. Some people don't even know. I just see it. So, they don't know none of this history.
True, they don't. They don't. But there's a prize at the end, so you do win money. So I think the prize is either $1,000 or $2,000 to the best prop or design for each table.
Okay, that's new. That's I didn't know that.
But you spent five to win. This is no. Yeah, you're still I mean, in the hole.
But yeah, you but still get your name out there.
True.
So you know what I mean? People
it's more
there?
Of a recognition thing.
They
right?
won.
Mm-hmm. Now, who do they cater to? Women, right? And I tell you, it's a Not flock sad. Of women. There's a flock of women that go out to this event, right?
I'm going in all black.
And there's not enough men at this event, mm-hmm. right? So what happens is there's a lot of couples at this event. So they do the whole love and Paris type of thing. So if you can't afford to go to Paris, this is like going to Paris. You know what I mean?
Again, false elitism.
Truth. Truth. And then it prompts for it to be a bunch of couples. So if you're a single woman and you see a dude there, 9 out of 10, he there with his girl.
Oh, no, he's not.
So it's another reminder on how single you actually are.
It's just a reminder how single you actually are.
Now, right, when you talk about pulling the carts and all these things going on, right, it's like, you know, when you were a kid and y'all did like a derby in front of the yard where everybody built the car and it was like, my car looked better than yours.
Mm-hmm. That's some real stuff.
I got more stuff than y'all.
We had buggies like the actual carriages. Mm-hmm. But go ahead.
That's
sorry.
That's up north. So that's the allure of the event. You know what I mean? So I'm in competition with the people next to me.
Uh-huh.
Right? If me and my husband... A wife doesn't have a planned event or anything, you know what I mean? Then this is that event. If we don't travel, this is that event. It's the Paris event, you know what I mean? But this is the first time they made people catch the train. And I thought that was kind of weird because you were going to Centennial Park, but you made people drive outside of the train station. So it's not like you drove to the train.
Wait a minute. You made people drive what?
So for instance, you drove to a building.
Mm-hmm.
That building took you to a train.
Oh,
you know,
they didn't drive to the train station,
right? Because it's a secret.
So I was wondering, was everybody parked at H.E. Holmes or something? I was wondering where that was. So you drove to somewhere and they gave because I saw these little martyr cards they gave them. Somebody took a picture of those. It's like I attended an event. I've seen all of this.
Right.
You didn't even enjoy the event because I've seen all these pictures of everything the entire night and all the videos.
And it's the first time it was hot because last year it was cold. And last year it was cold.
This time of year? It was early, I thought.
It was actually later.
It was October?
It was actually later. It was closer to October.
Okay.
But it was actually cold because everybody was out there freezing. You know what I mean?
That makes it even worse.
Yeah.
That makes it more. It sucks even more.
Now,
so
really angry.
Make some hot cocoa.
So and I let Pedro get through all that so he can kind of hit the points from being coming from his position actually going. Where the joy should be. But you gotta comment on this event?
Oh no, I don't really care too much about it.
We're talking about it.
I know.
On radio. It's a conversation.
No. Next topic. Move on.
Best. I really don't care. Too much
I don't want to say nothing about that.
I'm not carrying my red wagon.
You gotta have an opinion.
Well, I'm really not a foodie person. I'm learning to eat more food. You know, seafood and things like that. So, I guess I don't know.
But you bring your own food.
I'm just saying, what do you want me to bring? Chicken and macaroni and cheese?
That's what a lot of people have bought.
That's
I'm sure they did.
I could stay home.
So,
well, you could pay extra. I think it's like an extra $50, and you can get the food that they cater. That's there.
Mm, is it, and that's buffet style. Or they drop it off at your table.
Drop this off.
Bring me one of them rotisserie chickens at table 7.
They use the Postmates.
Oh, got it. Nigga in a champion Uber hood, pull up in a scooter, a Vespa, and get you a bag of Wendy's.
They got the Uber cars coming in all white Uber cars.
So what you had to say about this? Your opinion.
This is my thing. I have learned at this point in my life, you can't knock it until you've tried it.
Mm, okay.
And that's the reality. Yes, I mean, common sense here as we kind of go over these little smaller details, it doesn't seem interesting. It seems like it's more work than anything. But the energy and the atmosphere might be a game changer.
Mm.
You know what had to be really tough?
What?
If you had to take a piss.
Mmm.
You got all white on.
And had to go to a porta potty.
See,
this is another thing that this is the glory. It's a lot of glory.
Yeah, I know how I feel about porta potties.
This is not gonna work for me. I want to get into they do have the you can buy the nice bathrooms, the trailers. So I don't know if they bought those. It makes sense to do that. The ones that you can walk in has a door and actually has a linoleum on the floor. You can buy those too. You can rent those.
I need a whole can of Lysol.
Pedro said that's not what they did.
Fabuloso.
So
man, you probably had to bring your own toilet and toilet paper.
Oh my god, it's white toilet paper. So those are the challenges that lie in this thing. Now, to your point, experience. I'm all about experiences, right? And I told go experience everything. Mm-hmm. Go see it. Once you go, be like, all right, I've gone. And that's what you said the first year. You're like, I went. I don't even have to go no more. If I never go again, it's cool. True. I went.
But
and
I don't mean to cut you off. But in all reality, once you get past the bus, setting up the table.
Sounds like the whole thing, Pedro, but go ahead.
No, it's not. It's actually like the first 15 minutes. It's like the first
continue.
You ain't lying. So
continue.
So after like setting up the table, doing your decorations, and like you actually ready, right? After that, it is a good time.
It's a party.
It is a good time. It's a good party. You meet good people. You mingle.
You know you can do this at Jazz Festival when it's free. I just want to let you know that. You can wear white. You can bring your own food. You can drink wine. You can party to music. You can do that at Jazz Festival. It's free. I'm just putting that out.
And I have to break. Because I'm saying, after I set up, I'm tired. I'm not ready to party now. Because I actually had to cook food. No, I had to thaw it out. I had to fly in from overseas. I had to put up the table. I had to nail stuff to the ground, put up the tent.
Jackson, this happened. All this happened before the event. Think about this.
And do they
You went shopping the week before that. You went to the grocery store. You had to really think about it. You drew a schematic of what your table is going to look like. The diagram of where we're setting up. It's a lot.
I needed a compass to get here.
All right, so that's part of
the experience.
The experience. So for instance,
what,
right,
the nomadic cave life?
Women enjoy planning a wedding, right?
Truth.
Because they could do, you know, what my colors are or what I want to have, so on and so forth. So this event actually gives them something to do, right? And what do women like to do? Spend money.
That's a damn shame.
So they get to go out and shop.
It's a very sexist comment, but we're gonna go with it.
Okay, I'm sorry.
You said me too. I'm sorry.
You said
I'm sorry.
But okay, so I said all that, and a lot of that sounds like Debbie Downer, a lot of negative. Okay,
it's a great event. It's a great event.
Where the joy should be, for one, I do want my people to go out and get some real class. don't borrow class for the day, because you can tell the low class from the one that actually have class at, even at this event, you can tell, like, all right, you ain't never been nowhere before. And you can see that. But where the joy should be is that it's, especially here in Atlanta, it started out as mostly Caucasian people at this event. And even in Atlanta, I think the first one was all Caucasian, but now it's mostly black.
But that's because of the city is mostly black,
correct. So. But what I'm going somewhere with that. So you got all these black people, and everybody's together, looking nice, and having a good time in the middle of the city. And the city has to pay attention. You have to pay attention to that. You have to make provisions, safety, all that for this group of black people to enjoy themselves. Love that. That's where part of the joy should be. The experience. I shouldn't, just like everything else, we shouldn't be able to see all of this on live. Like, who you doing that for? Like, you're doing that again, it's elitism. You're like, I made it to Dinner on Blanc. You didn't. Just enjoy it then. enjoy it.
I appreciate the people that do that, though, that broadcast, because then I could pick up customers because I'm like, oh, you like that event? Oh, you definitely love mine.
Smart. Okay.
Smart. Smart.
And guess what? You don't have to put a table together.
True. Mm-hmm. You was at home. So you don't have to put anything together. So I think the joy does need to be in the event, having a good time. Once you get past all that, actually enjoying yourself. Those that went as couples, guys suck at planning dates. We talked about this a little while ago. True. Fellas, if your lady wants you to go and you can't plan and you suck at planning dates, mm-hmm. probably should say yes to this. Yeah. Because if you sucked every other week, you the man that night. Me and my man went and you got this fantastic. Yeah, whatever. So you
and then
go.
Other women looking at you, so you let her know, don't you mess up.
This is the other thing. If single fellas, if you're in the market and you are out here hunting for women, we suck at that too.
True.
We keep going to the guy. Go to the places where all the guys are. You at the sports bar. You at the game. You at different cities because girls at the game here. Yeah. But you're at places where their women don't typically go. Women get that wrong. Men get that wrong. We go where. Like it's a middle school party. All the guys over here, all the girls over here. It's like, that's why y'all can't find each other. So if you're a single guy hunting for women and you can't get on this list, super smart to be there. You is like shooting crabs in a barrel because they're a little bit looser. They're a little bit more friendly. They like, I came by myself. You look good. You can win. This is like, it's the winningest move ever. Like if you a guy,
looser,
say yes.
Friendly.
Say yes.
Say yes,
because
you can win. Go. That's the first thing Pedro said. Who are they doing this for? Women. It's a gaggle of women everywhere. Everybody dressed in white. Some people got their booty out, little side boob showing off. And you go there and bring your one plate, your one table. It's like having a puppy at the park, dog. Go by yourself. Don't tell your boys nothing. Just go. And you be like, she be like, oh, you by yourself? Yeah, I ain't even bring no chicken.
Yeah, girl. Yeah.
What you got? You got chicken salad? Yeah, I like that.
I got a Popeye chicken sandwich.
you bought spaghetti. I like spaghetti.
But you ain't there with six.
I ain't taking no red Kool-Aid. We ain't got no white. You got Sprite? Sprite.
That's Sprite. Yeah,
Sprite tonight.
Exactly. Sprite is safe.
So for guys, I think that's it's a good move. And I feel like that's where the joy should be. The joy shouldn't be looking down your nose at each other and saying you ain't get invited or na 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 boo boo. It always just feels like that from some of the social media posts. And again, as Ace Red said, mm-hmm. everybody's winning on Instagram. So
and next time we should broadcast from there. We should be in all white.
But we gotta get invited.
Man, so Pedro went, so he could invite you. True. And then you invite me. So
I could have went the last 2 years. I refuse.
I went both years, but listen, right?
So you did go this weekend?
No, I ain't go this weekend.
Oh, you
weekend.
Went, two,
I
years
went 2 years
prior. Super. Yeah.
You know, but, and I'm gonna say this, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you just said it. Take the fellas. Like if it's five of y'all, go.
Because
let me tell you, them women, once you get to like the last 50 minutes,
winning.
You win it.
The last 50 minutes.
Because they didn't play it. Yeah. After you spent 30 hours sweating. But yeah, they didn't watch everybody slow dance and all this. And they dolo. They didn't went to the porta potty and took off their drawers. It's a. Oh, wait a minute. Never
mind. You playing. But it's true. Let me tell you something. I'm going to say this real quick.
Lady like draws. Who wear draws?
You know what? Exactly. It's all white
party. I tell y'all off.
Yeah. Okay. This win.
This is just as bad as the baked goods.
No. No doing it in the porta potty. That's disgusting.
Ew.
You have stuff all over your white.
That's disgusting.
You come out with pudding on your white.
Anyway, so I mean, it's a no for me, but there's some reasons for it to be yes for a lot of people. Go ahead, make it happen. And the other thing is, maybe I'm a little also since we do events, and I've been to a lot of things and a lot of places that it don't tickle my fancy, quote unquote. It doesn't really get me excited because I'm like, all right, great, it's another event.
But you a man as well.
Other thing,
you know what I mean?
Probably
so. It's like, you know, if it was,
but I get dressed up all the time too.
Yeah, true.
So all those things that people don't get to do, they're looking for. Mm-hmm. To your point, you say it gives them something to do.
Mm-hmm. But it's like if you were spoiled. Like if the Mets were in town and they were doing an all white event at the baseball stadium.
All white jerseys.
All white.
All
jerseys.
White uniforms.
Mm-hmm. All white uniforms.
Throwbacks.
Throwbacks.
Pinstripe. Mm-hmm.
Pinstripe.
Strawberry.
Right. And you had to bring your own food, your own beer.
Not gonna do that. Right. Not gonna do that.
You still would have
went. I'm probably not gonna do that. I might go, but I'm not gonna do that. So we're gonna blow through this break. I just wanna let y'all know, unless y'all need it. Hell with this break.
Hell with this break.
Hell with this next break. This next segment is brought to you by us. We like to do, we talk about business, we talk about technology. We got to give Pedro a moment for Biz Tech. What you got for us, Pedro?
Que pasa.
We blew past que pasa.
We did. We did throw back.
But that's okay.
But, you know.
I did this on purpose because I wanted to talk about what we talked about.
Cool. We will. But I do want to give a special shout out to Jarrell Jerome, all right, who won an Emmy last night for When They See Us.
Jarrell Jerome, and he played whose character?
He played Corey Watts.
Played Corey, yeah. Man.
Congratulations.
He deserved that.
Big time.
But mm-hmm. He also broke records, right? Mm-hmm. So he's the first.
Most people crying.
He's the first Latino to win an Emmy ever.
Really?
Oh, wow. Ever. Right.
Really? First of all, let's just a moment of silence. I didn't know he was Latino.
True.
He's Afro-Peruvian.
He's my Dominican brother.
Moving on.
He's my Dominican brother.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah, because when he started his speech, he said, man, I feel like I should be in Brooklyn watching the game or something. That's how he started his speech. Okay. Go ahead.
And he's also the youngest to win an Emmy. At 21.
He's 21. 21-year-old Latino.
21.
With a black face. They call him a black man in the streets.
Truth.
Mm-hmm.
Truth.
But he won. That's what's up, man. Now, how many of you, everybody here has seen that, right?
Classic.
Everybody's seen it.
Great.
This is us.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, everybody's seen it. When I tell you. Everybody, you've seen it too.
When they see us, I mean, this is us.
I mean,
you haven't seen it?
No.
Why have you not seen it? You are dark skinned, sir.
He's not black enough.
You are dark skinned. Where are you from, sir?
Connecticut.
Straight up.
You are dark skinned from Connecticut. You should have seen. You definitely should have seen this.
Next time you see me, I'll let you know.
I need a book report. All right, moving on.
I want a whole 2-page essay.
This is us.
Uh huh. I'm not gonna hold that against you, but yeah, I need you to see this. Okay. You're a minority as well, sir. they will lock you up.
I feel like I almost had to pause through it though, because the first 20 minutes like stressed me out.
It's too much, y'all. First episode, I wanted to punch TV people, punch babies. It was a lot of stuff I wanted to do.
Like, it was so spot on, but you just like, yo, why would you do that? I can't watch this. I can't do this, but what's happening?
Carry on.
But it was a lot of information that we didn't know about.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And I think about like us growing up, because like I ain't crying in like 20 years. But when I saw that episode,
bro, you cried 2 weeks ago.
I'm not you, ho. We both might be light skinned, but that's more you. That's more you, brother.
Hey.
But no, episode 4, mm-hmm. when it was Corey's episode. And yeah. I was sitting there, I was like, yo, this 99% was me. Like, I could have literally been in jail.
Yeah.
For the next 30 years, you know what I mean? And seeing everything that he went through.
Yeah.
Bro, it just broke me down.
Word?
And I cried. And my wife looked at me and was like, you ain't cried at our wedding? You just cried when we had kids?
It's just like a woman to pick that out. That's what she picked out?
Women, you've been like that's what you got out of all this. That's what you got.
That's what you got out of this
all this right here. That's what you got.
Yo, Pedro, I'm going to tell you, for real, I've been so high to her. Like, it's for that moment, I've been so mad at her. Is that what you picked out? And real, I'm joking about it, but that's what you picked out?
That's what you saw.
That's what you saw.
You didn't even have the depth of thought.
Right.
That's what you picked?
That's what you picked.
I'm talking about I've been on fire. I've been on fire.
What? In a
high voice. After I wipe my face, boy, it'd be hot, boy. I'm saying, yo, we might not be talking right now.
I'm sick of this.
She would slept on the couch. But, go ahead, carry on.
But it was a great movie. It was a great movie.
Congratulations to him. What's his name again?
I just said Jarrell Jerome.
Jarrell Jerome. He got two first names.
Jarrell, he do.
Jarrell Jerome. He really black.
Rome in the house.
He really black.
Like, how did that work over the intercom? Please send Jarrell Jerome to the office.
Well, who? Which both of us?
Which one?
Both
of
us.
Both of them.
Jarrell Jerome. Okay. All right, y'all. So, Biz Tech.
Mm-hmm.
Biz Tech.
This
Drum.
Are you twins? Did you have
Afro?
Did you be confused?
All right, send them in.
Them. Is Jarrell here?
Both of y'all go to the office.
Like, which one's in trouble the most?
Jarrell Drum. You walk in. So where's Jarrell?
Which one really in trouble?
Jarrell may show up all year, but Jarrell came to school.
Jarrell got perfect attendance. Right. Jarrell ain't sure. All right, I'm sorry. Tangent. Carry on.
All right, so there's a company that is trying to change the way we visit the doctor, right? So there's a biometric scanner, right? So you stand on it. You take your shoes off, and you stand on it, and it scans your whole body, right? Mm-hmm. And it tells you what's wrong. Like, literally, it tells you what's wrong. Now they saying that this machine
so many jokes.
Will eliminate copays, right? And actually having to go to the doctor. So you know when most people be like, oh man, my head hurt. I think I need to go to the doctor. And then you stand on the machine and you realize you have migraines because you're sensitive. Migraines. You know what I mean? All
right. So,
does this machine have a voice? It does. Hey, you dying.
You
dying.
You need help.
Good Lord, you big.
You're diabetic.
You got the monkey.
You got that sugar.
Hey, the monkeys.
You got that sugar. You need one of them fancy Kit Kats. I ain't care.
But
that's that gout.
Ooh, wait.
Bad surgery. You know what I mean? Your butt done.
We tangent.
You got a lumpy butt. Oh,
too many ounces in that butt.
Lipo for you.
But
last one, you're gonna die.
Oh, sorry.
I'm sorry.
Okay. You good? You good? But
this machine's voices in my head.
I can hear it. I shouldn't have did that. Strapped up.
That thing scared you. Like you ain't gonna make it to Monday.
Call the ambulance.
That is so true, though. This is gonna help with insurance. So you don't need any insurance. You don't need anything. You can actually go find out where your health status is, right? Unfortunately, it's not in the hood. You know what I mean? It's actually in like good neighborhoods. So
go figure,
right?
Oh, so you gotta have a proper voice. You're gonna die, sir.
Yeah. It's gonna be Siri.
Siri.
How much is this device?
Alexa.
All right.
Play You Dying. Alexa, play End of the Road.
This is the end of the road.
Oh my. Let me select a song for your current condition.
Highway to Hell.
What if that joke pull up Eddie Murphy? The upper room.
God damn it, these people.
All right, I'm sorry.
They don't know about that joke in that neighborhood.
You should probably be late. You should be late. You should have said this last.
I know, right? I should have. But all jokes aside. This would be really good for the health.
No, put the joke right here. Why you got to put it to the side?
I want my jokes as the main course.
Right.
You got a lump in your joke and it can't decide. You know? But
I'm sweating.
Most people don't go to the doctor. Most people don't go to the hospital at all.
Mm-hmm.
And the biggest reason for that is because most people don't want to know what's wrong with them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and the other reason is they can't afford it.
Mm-hmm.
So this system would be really good for that. Like it actually helps you, well, we hope that it actually helps you find out what's actually wrong.
So is this machine going to be kind of like the blood pressure machine is in Walmart? Like you just go step on it?
No, it's a biometric scanner. So you actually stand on it and it rotates you as it scans your body.
So what if it's about to blurt out something you don't want your girl to know or your wife? Like, oh, shut it down.
You burn it. Oh, you burn it.
If you burn it, your wife probably burning too.
True.
You know what I mean?
Burning bush.
So you already in trouble. You're already in trouble.
Burning bush like Moses.
But there was a study that came out, right? And it was like the number one causes of death, right? So number one on that list
stress.
Was
misdiagnosis.
Was heart disease,
mm-hmm.
right? Number two was blood pressure. And number three was misdiagnosis.
Oh.
So
You think about that.
That's number three.
It's number three on the list.
Cause of death, you said?
Cause of death.
Jesus Christ.
It's misdiagnosed. So when you go that to the doctor and they say, hey, what's wrong with you? Oh, I just got a headache.
Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? You got a tumor.
But you actually
It's not a tumor.
You know, or you don't have the insurance, so they're not going to run all the tests on you. So you end up dying.
Jesus.
Damn. Morbid.
So.
That escalated.
No, it's real, man. You've never. I've heard kinesis of scenarios and cases where people. Have been with the nurse. I'm in
making up
scenarios and cases.
Wasn't that a basketball school?
Oh, that's what that was. I didn't know what it was. I just let it go.
Yeah.
Jesus. Yeah. Hey, man. I mixed two words. Okay, cut me some slack. But
in this segment of kinesis. But
have you ever been? It was good school.
To kinesis. But no, but I've had people that have actually told me they've went to the doctor and the doctor will Google their symptoms.
Google never help.
Exactly.
You could be like, I got a runny nose. Right. Google, like, he's dying of something.
You died in 48 hours.
Cancer.
See a couple of
AIDS. Everything on all lead to cancer and AIDS. Everything.
You need to see a doctor.
WebMD is the doctor. I mean, WebMD is the devil. Don't look at it.
WebMD is
cancer
the devil.
And AIDS. Yeah, you would die.
But that's a serious thing. So, I mean, I agree with that.
Shit.
Okay, so.
You done messed it up.
No, I didn't.
You did miss that biometric scanner, boy.
Biometric scanner is serious.
You're on the way there.
All right, so top-rated gifts. Is that what you want to talk about? Or what did you want to talk about?
No,
you said you want to talk about something. I want to make sure I don't miss that.
It's your segment. Go ahead.
Tell me.
I have no clue what I said.
You sure? You was like, Pedro, I want to talk to you about something.
Hey, you see him right now?
I forgot.
He doesn't have a clue.
Gotcha.
He doesn't have a clue. He's trying to stop chuckling.
Well, you did send something to us today about those motorcycles.
Yes.
Yeah. RC motorcycles, and I actually looked them up. They're really dope.
Hey, man, we need to get some. Go raise them Jones. I want to. We're children.
I was committed. Especially when I see that Joker roll up. I was like, what kind of person is this?
I want that.
Oh, this is a... Oh, okay.
Correct. I actually do want that. So, a lot of people have been going to Walmart lately, right?
Yeah, nothing new. I mean, you just act like it's a wave.
Talking about people in general, I'm like, I just not.
Just people in general.
It's not a wave, nigga.
I don't know. It's not in my neighborhood. I don't know.
Target.
I'm just playing.
He's in the neighborhood with that biometric scanner.
Go ahead.
So if you walked into Walmart lately, there's actually now a open and close like sensor. So like, I thought it was kind of weird because like you walk through the door, right, and you know where you'd be walking down the aisle to get to like the fruit or anything else. There's like a little.
It's a gate.
It's like a gate there now.
Yeah, like so they want you, but. You got to bring the carts in. I don't understand what the gate is for. But go ahead. You're obviously going to say it.
So this gate, I guess, well.
I don't know. Or to keep crime out, I keep my ass in.
A little bit of both.
Uh-huh.
You know, so you think about it. This gate scans you, right, to let you in. And I think it also has a metal detector as well that's included. So it notifies, hey, you might be carrying.
It's metal.
You know what I mean? So you could no longer carry in Walmart anymore.
That's what.
Yeah, you no longer have the right to carry in Walmart anymore.
But they sell them to you. Okay.
You can walk out with them. You can't walk
in. Can't walk back in.
You know what I mean? But I thought it was strange. So I was like, well, damn, like, what if I just went around it, though? Because it ain't like it's a barricade where I can't not go around.
Yes.
So who designed this thing?
But they probably think a lot of people don't know what it is when they pull up on it, so.
I definitely wouldn't have thought that this metal thing was a metal detector.
Well, maybe when you think you're going around, it's another one.
That don't blow nobody's mind. That don't blow nobody's mind that this metal thing is the metal detector. It's chrome. I don't understand. What did that detect itself? I just don't understand how this works. So it definitely blew my mind.
Now, is this in the upper neighborhoods or is it in the...
I was on Thornton Road today and I saw it. I don't know what type of neighborhood that is.
Out there, bro.
It sounds like Thornton Road.
Thornton Road.
Yeah, it's everywhere. I've seen it in quite a few different Walmarts. And I didn't know what it was because I was like, this doesn't keep carts out or in. So what is this thing? You know what I mean? I was like, what? It seemed
which
like.
Is this?
Because I don't believe in things for no reason. I'm like, this has no purpose. What is this? I was angry about it, actually.
This rock.
So it was stealth. It was hiding in plain sight. So it's.
Yeah, I mean, it makes sense. I guess to somebody. I don't know what the design is on that.
Because you can go around it.
Right, you can just walk around. Like, I can just go down the aisle and cut through. Like,
and if you come in the garden side, it's not one down there.
Correct. It's not even one on the other side. It was only by...
Definitely means I've spent too much time at Walmart.
It was only by the produce section. So,
Walmart.
The grocery side. It was only on the grocery side.
Oh, the one on our side. my side of town. It's on both entrances, but it's definitely one over there by the guard. So that's crazy. Mm.
All right, so women, we love y'all. Y'all listen to this show. What this we appreciate.
We got to go.
We got to go, bro.
But real, but real quick, don't be as nice at work as you usually are. You know what I mean?
What?
Don't be what as the? Nice at work as you usually are.
Sir, I reason usually cut that, you off.
The reason for that is because it's being devalued. So most women are nice. Most people are nice at work, right? But women get a bad rap for being nice, so they feel like you're not in a position of being empowered or being able to give direction.
I think that's a lose-lose, though.
This sounds like a discussion we'll have offline. We got to get ready to go, man. Don't be nice at work. Don't be nice at work. Don't be a stuck up.
Don't be stuck up.
Listen,
don't be stuck
up. Come see. We will be at an event somewhere doing something. Go to the website, jason804jasoncarey.net. Make sure you go by the website. Make sure you can see the support. Each and every one of us individually and collectively. You see us somewhere, go. Republic on Fridays now. So go check that out. We're going to be doing some other stuff, man. We missed all the festivals. There was a wine festival, Rosé festival, a lot of festivals this weekend.
Sneaker Fest. I was mad about that.
Yeah, Sneaker Con was this weekend, too. So I just wore my sneakers and all. But anyway, we got to get out of here. Do what you love. Love what you do. Remember, in all things, the only thing holding you back
is you.
We out of here.
Peace out.
Oh, wow.
Holla at your boy.
Next in a glass in a text, save an Instagram picture, the symbol of success. Jay Bizzle and you listening to Hova. Here comes Monday, 7 p.m., you know what? Grab your phone, grab your tablet, computer.